Which shows the length of the rectangle measured correctly? All right. So here we have this green rectangle. And let's see, how did we measure it? We have 1 centimeter right over here. And then we put another centimeter right over here. And they say two rulers measure the rectangle side to side. Well, this makes sense, because we can say, look, if from here to here, from the beginning of the rectangle to the middle is 1 centimeter, and then it's another centimeter that gets us to the other side, to the right side, then we know that this is going to be 2 centimeters long, 1 and 2. So I'm pretty sure this is measured correctly, but let's just make sure that the other two don't really measure the rectangle correctly. So this one right over here, you have 1 centimeter and another centimeter, but you're leaving a gap right over here. And you can't leave a gap here. You want to measure what this distance is. And you notice that this ends to the right of the rectangle. So this isn't a good way of measuring it. And this way, you're not going all the way, the entire length of the rectangle. So this, you're coming up short. You need to measure the entire length. You need to start on the left side, which they did, but you need to go all the way without any gaps and without overlapping the rulers in any way to get to this side. So this isn't right either. So let's keep doing these. Which shows the length of the eraser measured correctly? So this one, well, once again, there's some weirdness over here. I don't even know what's happening, but the entire ruler isn't even getting to the entire length of this rectangle. So this isn't measured correctly. And they say two rulers measure the eraser and overlap. Oh, I see. This is kind of the ruler's a little bit transparent. So this one is overlapping with the one underneath. So you definitely don't want to do that. You want to put them right next to each other without a gap. And you want to get all the way to the edge of this rectangle. So this one, you have a gap, and you're actually going beyond the edge of the rectangle, so that's not good. Here, you have no overlap and no gap right over here. They're just right next to each other. And we're starting at the left side of this rectangle, and we're going exactly to the right side. We're not overstepping it, or we're not underdoing it. So this is going to be right. This is a lot of fun. Let's do, okay, this is interesting. What is the length of the floor of the bank in meters? So this is a picture of a bank. I guess this is the big money in the bank. Those are big dollar bills, and those are big coins. Drag the ruler to make the measurement, and this is in meters. So I can click on this, and then I can put it, remember, I don't want to do this. This would be wrong, because I want to start measuring right at the edge of the bank. So I want to do it like that, and I see, okay, the length of the bank. Well, how much is that? Well, you see this right wall right over here. It's right at 4 meters. So this is going to be 4 meters long. Let's do another one. What is the length of Maria's backyard in meters? Drag the ruler to make the measurement. So once again, you don't want to do something like this where you're starting to measure before the garden even starts. You're starting to measure too late. You want to measure right at the edge. Right over there. So that's where the garden starts. So that's where your ruler should start, measuring 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Looks pretty close. Let's see. It looks pretty close to 8 meters right over here. So yeah, this length of this is 8 meters. It looks pretty close. I'll say 8. All right, let's do one more of these. What is the length of the tray of cookies in centimeters? And when they say length, they mean length actually means the longest dimension, if you have a width and a length. And so the longest dimension of a tray of cookies is going to be this side right over here. You don't want to measure that side up there. That would not be the length. The length, if people don't tell you otherwise, it's the longest dimension. So we want to measure, let me make sure I don't lose my ruler. We want to measure along the top or along the bottom, and we see that it is, once again, we don't want to do this. That would be starting the ruler too far to the left. And you don't want to do this, starting the ruler too far to the right. You want to put it right at the edge, right over there. My ruler isn't perfectly straight. And we see that this cookie tray is right at about 8 centimeters. 8 centimeters. And we're done.